Hey, Bad Buddies!
I'm not doing this for Bad Buddies. I'm doing this as a dedication to Jaden at the Cowl Vault. And I'll work, but I don't know that you're gonna get anything out of this, and you're probably not gonna do it at home. Oh, on the table? Okay. So I took pictures of these, I listed them for highest bidder, because they're the first ones. And if they don't go high enough, then who cares? It's over. It's so funny, I haven't listed any small things for a long time, like I finished playing Fallout 4, that's what I did during the pandemic quarantine. I tried Assassin's Creed Black Flag, because I like pirates. It was a little stiff, it was like 2014, so it wasn't as good as I would have liked it to been. So as I'm working here, I'm just going to talk a little bit. Anyway, I'm using this electric knife. I like to make this different for me than it is for someone else. I'm going to go ahead and work on the details a little bit. I'm going to make them larger and deeper. And I'm going to add to them. I'm placing this right in the lines that are on here already. I'm going to alter the lines and add to them. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to plasti dip this, stretch it and size it. And I'm going to go ahead and do some aging on it and make it itself, make it its own thing for me. So as soon as you get it to catch, it stays in its place. And then it's just a question of how long you want to go. But at least you know but the cut's being made uniformly. So then, whenever I find like a mark like this, I say, okay, what else can I do? I'm gonna try to be an artist as I go. it won't be accurate, it'll be something else. But it'll be different than the other cowls. Like if I was sculpting and I made these lines go farther, well on my cowl, they will go farther. On no one else's cowl will they go farther. So that's one of the ways of customizing. I don't know if you guys have thought of this before, but latex is a great thing. You can customize it in so many ways. I've just been going around and deepening these. And my thought was, as I'm working, it'll occur to me what else I want to do. But I'm looking at this and I'm saying, maybe it won't occur to me what I want to do. Maybe I won't do anything more than just deepen these, and that'll be enough. But I am going to do a few other things. Whenever I see something, I want to see like a mark like that. You know, that wasn't there. I could obviously just paint it. But I don't want to just paint it. I want it to be part of the detail. Two marks like that. Now, getting symmetry on the other side is a little tricky, but I think I'll get it. As long as I'm close, it's going to have the lived-in look. That's pretty close. Okay, so far, so good. Okay, it looks pretty good, but it needs to go in a little bit more. Because I know I'm going to rub this down with mineral spirits, and that's going to blend it in, and that depression's going to be there. So go over to the other side, do that one. Just gonna score that a little bit, and I can do some things with my painting when I get in there. Now, also, I wanna do some deliberate damage that isn't painted on effect, but actually a real effect. It's a great place right here for a line that it doesn't have one, but I'm doing it. It could very easily have a line there, so now it does. And I want to do the exact same thing to the other side. Boom. Now it's got a line. So it's a little bit different. What else can I do? Ah. Good place for a line. Good. Go a little farther on there. Sure, that works. Why not? This was an imperfect, and I'm saving it for myself because I don't care if it's an imperfect because I know what I'm going to do with it. Why would I keep a perfect for myself? That's dumb. Especially if I'm going to make it imperfect. Let that line continue. Okay, I like it. One's a little rougher, there. Okay, so that's about all I'm gonna do with the electric knife. Just kind of a thought, hey, did you think you could use an electric knife and scratch new lines on latex? Yes, you can. I wouldn't recommend it on your thing because as soon as you cut a little bit, it's gonna make it where it wants to cut and go all the way through. You don't have to worry about that with latex. So yet another thing you can do to latex in the customization process. I just wanted to say, Jaden, you're the most honest, straightforward guy that I know on YouTube, other than me. You have a great, I'm into this. I just assume everyone else will be, and guess what? They are. Why? Because you care. And how many of them are there for the cowls? Yeah, they're there for the cowls, but I'm not. I'm there, I found you because of the cowls. I'm there because of you. And there are some people that say they're here because of me. Why? Because I'm a unique character. I do things that they found me. They know I do bad stuff. But I'm the same thing as you. I have a life where if I showed everything, I could do a whole YouTube channel. It's just, hey, let's see what Paul does. Well, I'd do that a little bit. I'd be done, right? And if you did it a little bit, you'd be done too. Bottom line is, you're going to have to learn to pace yourself. And I'm going to have to learn to pace myself. I'm going to have to learn to live by my own rules. But you've got a lot of things that you can do that don't involve cowls. And I would do it like I do. I do unconscious counseling, but also on this a little bit. I do some record keeping. I do like therapeutic. I play the drums, you play the guitar and sing. I do some of the things that I do for therapeutic, artistic outlets. Some may hit, some may not. Some your regular people may be interested, some maybe not. But if you do it for you, you'll always be getting the therapeutic benefit out of it. I'm not saying you're going to be successful. You might not get even into 2,000. I can't even keep the 1,000 I've got. But that's not the point. Instead of saying, oh, I'm down, I don't know what else to do. The reason why you're doing that is because you're hitting an imagination wall. Imagine that you're, who you are, is worth something. And you didn't have to do that stuff. I know that who I am is worth something, and I don't have to do this stuff. But I know that even though it's worth something, and I'm solid on that, I know that if I just do that, there's a lot of people out there living interesting lives. But I just want to say, I feel you. I know what you're going through. Be true to yourself and feel good. And be creative and be honest and be yourself and be happy. Don't let something like your channel let you down. Let's face it, if you were rich, you probably only have like 500 cows. Okay, so that would be an end to your channel anyway, even if you were well off. What I'm saying is, go ahead and force your viewers like I do to listen to some of your thoughts and see a few of your other things. If they come back, they're yours. If they don't, they never were. You know, it's like if you love something, set it free. If it comes back, it's yours. If it didn't, it never was. Have that confidence. I'm going to try to do that. I'm on the same page with you. And I have to say to myself, what could I do every day that I would do and I'm glad I did? Because I share with myself when I'm older, or my kids or my family, or who knows? If it's worth doing, it's worth doing on video. I'm going to do this thing shortly. One of my videos is going to be all about me and a trunk of my things from my childhood. I'm going to open that up and I'm going to talk about it. Who the heck would care about that? Maybe somebody that's known me for 20 years might want to say, a little bit more about Paul. But my family, my grandkids one day, maybe other people. Like, for instance, I was going along collecting junk one day. Saw somebody left their garbage open. Oh, and the guy that used to work here, he did harps. He's passed away. He left some things. And I kept so many of the things here. Like, for instance, this. Every single time I take my regular little tool pack and grab for my glue and everything, that rings a little bit and dings around in there, keeping the guy alive that was here. I'll never know him, but he was important. How do I know that? Well, because he made harps and tuned harps. You're important. I'm important. Just going through the garbage. Little cigar box. I thought, oh, that's nice. It's a cigar box. I said, I can use a cigar box to store things in. I got here and I go, oh, look at this. This guy probably passed away. Because why would you throw this out? Elvis Costello. His draft card. So I know who he is. Went to a couple of movies and had the glasses. Different things in here. I don't know who this guy is. But I kept this from going to the dump. He's got a cigar box full of memories, and he won't keep it or care, but I will. You could call me a hoarder if you want to, but I only select what I'm going to hold on to, and there's reason for it. This, to me, says this guy needed someone to know he was important, and even though I'll never meet him, I'm going to let him know he is. Well, you're alive. I'm telling you, you are. I know I am, and I know you are, but if you come to define your importance based on whatever it was you were showing or describing, and you come to an end on that, well, that doesn't make your importance less, but it could make you think it does. And I want to be one of the people that says, don't ever do that, don't ever think that, it's not true. You're a real person, a genuine person, a person I can tell has something to say, something to think, and a confidence, and an originality, and a creativity, and a self-awareness to come forth and just show it. Just whatever you say comes right out. That's important. You may go through your whole life and nobody will ever reward you for it. That's possible. You may go through your whole life, and maybe other people, maybe a few others will tell you what I'm telling you today, but I want you to go through your life and know that you've been noticed by someone like me that takes the time to look at those things and evaluate them. And I want you to know that if a few other people, I see a few other people are making comments, they tell you positive things, hey, hang in there. In a generic way, that's good. I want you to know that I'm just one more voice that can tell you on your low times, don't ever think that. Don't ever think that. Always have confidence to go on and be true to yourself and be happy and do whatever you think you need to do. Put it out there. Maybe you'll never look at it, like a diary. Maybe you will. But make sure you enjoy it while you do it. Make sure you do it enough for yourself. So one guy said, comment on my last video, I think, said, you almost get to the point of preaching. Okay, maybe part of that is me. I'm not going to apologize for it. Maybe part of that is what I deem the most important. You ain't seen nothing. You want to see about preaching, I could go a lot further than that. I don't do it, so I'm very restrained. I do much more opening up my heart and everything, and my mind and my conscience, unconscious counseling 101. But that's neither here nor there. I'm going to go on to the next video with this and show you as I go along in steps rather than doing it now. This is mostly about Jaden and me and Cowl and behind the mask. It is what it is. That's good. You are what you are, and that's good. And Mr. Rogers, I know you probably don't know who Mr. Rogers is. He would say that to the television. Who knows what he's looking at? Who knows who's looking at him? And he'd say, you're important. There's nobody like you. And that's the truth. We need to value the sanctity of life. We need to revere the individual that tries and puts forth an effort. We need to heighten them when they're down. We need to put a spotlight on them when there's so much worthlessness on the internet and so much bickering and negativity and junk that messes up our world. When somebody comes through and tries to do something decent and honorable, and just because he's passionate about it, even, straightforward. And you always say something at the end of your video, I can't remember the exact words, very positive note. I used to do a mantra like that on Conscious Counseling. I keep forgetting to do it, but I'll do it on this one. I used to end the videos with, if everyone doesn't get you down a little, you ain't high enough. And I'll leave with that. Bet buddies, Jaden, people of the world, myself, ah, there you are, 20 years from now. I thought you'd tune back in. Talk to you all later, or not, but hey, I'm glad I've done what I've done. And I bet you're glad you've already done what you've done. Let tomorrow be a whole new thing. Clean slate. Do a little bit more of the same. Do something totally different. Whatever you want that makes you happy and gives you a creative outlet. I'll check it out. And I think some others will too. Talk to you later.